Hello students,
I'm Tonmoy. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecules. So today we will discuss preparation of another 6 member heterocyclic compound, that is quinoline. Okay, it's a, you can say, benzopyridine derivative. Previously I have discussed about the preparation of pyridine. Now you can say it's a stepwise movement towards higher homologs. Okay, so So today's lecture will mainly cover few things like the basic idea or background or synthesis of reagent. Second is mechanism of this reaction, role of individual reagent and aromaticity. Okay, so a lot of things to be learned. Let's start. As you can see that this reaction is named as Scrub reaction. Okay, and it produces quinoline. So this is actually quinoline. It's a benzopyridine. So how it's produced? It's produced by the reaction of aniline plus this is glycerol and produces this quinoline derivative in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid and nitrobenzene and under refluxing condition. By the way, actually the reaction condition is harsh. Okay, so I'll explain how to deal with this. So let's go to the background. So what happens first, this is the glycerol. How this is obtained? This is obtained from saponification, or better to say hydrolysis of fat, which produces glycerol. Fine, in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, what happens? This undergo dehydration. So what is, so this middle hydroxyl gets protonated. So what it result? It result OH2OH. Logically, other can also protonate, but this protonation is effective because I'll explain why. So what happens? This in next step undergo elimination, and what it resulted? It resulted a carbocation formation. See, this is OH, this is OH. Why this carbocation? Actually, formation of this carbocation is most stable because there are 2 plus 2, 4 hydrogen for hyperconjugation. But if you think about this side, only one hydrogen available for hyperconjugation. So that's the stability of the carbocation is the driving force for the elimination of this particular OH group. This one. Fine. In next step, what happens? See, actually, you have already read about pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. I have already made a dedicated video about pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. Please visit that for better understanding. So what happens here? Actually, this is like a pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. Think, it's a 2 alcohol, so it's a 1,2-diol. Means pinacol means that kind of chemical thing you can see. So similar property, just forget about this third hydroxyl, okay, for right now. So what happens? It pushes and this hydride migrates here. So what it resulted? It resulted in double bond here. This is OH having plus. Okay, now see the plus charge is shifted now. These two hydrogen. Fine. And here is one hydroxyl. So in next step, it will remove this hydrogen to become neutral. And another thing, there is another hydroxyl, and you can see this is a carbonyl compound, means aldehyde. It is an aldehyde. This is alpha position. This is beta position. This is gamma. Okay. So now what happens? I made a mistake, I guess. 1, 2, 3 gamma. I guess miss, not gamma. So this is. Okay, so this is beta hydroxy compound. So I have already explained in aldol condensation that this beta hydroxy carbonyl compound, there is a dedicated video about aldol condensation. Please visit that if you have any problem. So what happens? Beta hydroxy carbonyl compound undergo facile dehydration in presence of acid or base to prepare alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Okay, so in presence of H plus, this converted into H2 plus. Similar consequence of aldol condensation. Please visit the video about aldol condensation if you have any problem about this. So this here, so first this is OH2, it leaves, and parallelly after that this proton is abstracted, so ultimately a double bond is formed. I know, but since I have explained, so I am not going to explain again. So what is the total process of this? So this is actually a pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement on glycerol. Okay, so on glycerol to get acrolein. It's a very important synthetic intermediate in reactions. Okay, so actually what we got acrolein. Actually glycerol is not the actual reactant. The actual reactant is acrolein. Why? Because this acrolein will now participate reaction with the aniline. Okay, so means actually better to say this, actually this is the dehydrated form, this acrolein aldehyde. Now when there is amine and there is aldehyde, what seems the simplest thing comes in our mind, that there will be a C-base formation. Means this hydrogen and this these two hydrogen and one oxygen will eliminate and produce C-base. But here the story is not like that. Why? Because this double bond is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. So what happens in this case? This case, what it produces? It produces this NH2 attacks here. It's a Michael addition on alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl. So this second it comes back. So this first, after attack this NH become NH plus and it releases proton, and ultimately it will result. I know I am little skipping these steps because you are in advanced stage. I believe you can understand. Otherwise, the video will be unnecessarily lengthy. Fine. So this is the product. Okay. Simple addition. One H is added to here and nitrogen is added to here. Alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Because it has a canonical form, you can think that this is O minus, this is plus. So this makes this canonical form in proofs that the electrophilic center is this, but it is softer. Fine, this. So in next step, what happens? In next step, see, medium is H2SO4, means concentrated acid is there. Okay, and what is the position now? Think from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 6. So let's redraw. Why? Then we'll understand what message I want to give. So exactly this. So this is hydrogen, this is NH, this 2 carbon, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, I guess I have made mistake. It's a 3 carbon unit. Oh, that's why I can't get the right one. So, 5, 5. So this, so what happens? This, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So consequently what happens? Now you can see this 1, 6. So if it undergo any condensation reaction, then it will produce a 6 member ring. And actually in presence of acid, what forms it remains in this? You can say that, sir, there is ammonia, why NH2? Definitely it will remain. But it is not our focus. So that's why you are not focusing on this part. Okay. So it will be in protonated form. What do I mean? This. Fine. Now next step, what happened? That this will attack. Since it's an electrophilic center. Okay. So this intramolecular Friedel Crafts, better to say Friedel gap reaction. Okay. Actually, here carbocation will be to Friedel gap alkylation, you may say, not acylation, because it's not an acid product. So what happened next? In next, this resulted in this. This is one hydrogen. This OH. This is the thing. Fine. Now, in next step, what is expected? Just think. Sorry, it is aromatic also. So plus charge is at this carbon, which is resonance stabilized by the nitrogen atom. Means, let me draw the chemical form. So this is the OH, this is the H, plus charge is resonance stabilized by the nitrogen. Plus charge is here. So now every atom is octet filled. Others, benzene's contribution there, I am not discussing. So what happened in next step? Next step is the aromatization reaction. Okay, so what do I mean? So just think that this proton will be abstracted and aromaticity will be gained. Why? Because gaining aromaticity is the most important thing. Okay, so so minus H plus, what it will result? This NH. Who can abstract this proton? Simply some other H, nitrogen or other molecules OH, they can abstract. So this is the aromatic. Now see, this is actually a benzyl alcohol, benzylic alcohol type molecule. So what can happen? And medium is constant sulfuric acid, so it is expected to be protonated. Fine. So it will leave, resulting in a benzyl carbocation formation. This next step, what happens? That there is a proton, so it will be eliminated. So it will be eliminated, and there will be a double bond formation. So what is the consequence? Is this? So this is the end of the reaction. So this is the product of the process. Means actually product of dehydration. Condensation reaction. Better to say condensation reactions. Condensation reactions. Now question, did we get quinoline? No, because there one double bond is there. We need to, and that is the reason we need to oxidize this molecule to get the aromaticity. Now question is, how can we do it? Actually aromatization is a kind of oxidation. So how to do this? We need a oxidizing agent. And for that case, different type of oxidant is used. What do I mean? Oxidant. So what are oxidants could be used? These oxidants are like nitrobenzene. Nitrobenzene, even you can say iron 3 plus, even you can say AS2O5 is a very strong because arsenic in plus 5 oxidation state. So what happens? That it oxidizes this part into corresponding double bond, and this molecule is getting aromaticity. So that is the driving force, that this molecule want to get aromatized, oxidized. So it undergo oxidation, consequently they will undergo reduction. For example, what happened to this nitrobenzene? If it's reduced, it converted into aniline, NH2. So you may think the story like that. So this is the oxidation. So this, in this way, oxidant are used. Now, see here, nitrobenzene is used as a oxidant. But one important information I believe you should know, that this reaction is a very harsh reaction. So lots of means very harsh reagent are there. So there is a chance of explosion, excessive heat generation, those things. Additionally, heating we are doing, so there is a chance of any explosion type thing. That's why sometimes you see ferrous sulfate is written. So ferrous sulfate dilutes the reaction mixture such that some extreme condition or accident could be avoided. So that is the role of ferrous sulfate. Fine. Sometimes you will find that a more derivative of nitrobenzene, because as I told, this nitrobenzene, fine, this nitrobenzene, some derivative of nitrobenzene, what do I mean? For example, you may consider G equal to fluoro derivative, sulfonic acid derivative, they are used in this reaction medium additionally. So this is the thing overall for oxidation, and the driving force is to get aromaticity. Okay, so the overall role of reagent, first of all, this is act as a source of nitrogen, and second, how you can obtain this? You can obtain this from benzene, first mix acid nitration, second reduction of nitrobenzene to aniline. This second, this is the source of actually the means alpha beta unsaturated compound, that is this acrolein. So role of sulfuric acid, this is actually the reagent for dehydration as well as ring formation, means this ring formation process. Second, role of nitrobenzene as a reducing agent, so heat under this condition. And another interesting point which I avoided, that the why there is no seed base formation. Actually there is some seed base formation, but at the end of the reaction we get this product. So we will say that this path is followed, but it doesn't mean that seed base doesn't, there is some very less amount of seed base, means that is actually pH N double bond CO this. So this is the seed base. And what happens? Sometimes this seed base, also this imine gets reduced, and this molecule get oxidized because it gets aromaticity stable. So that sometimes also does as the role of oxidizing agent. So that's a side reaction. So this is the overall discussion for step reaction. So it has an application. For example, you can think that preparation of 1,10 phenanthroid. I'll explain in the next video. So this is the overall discussion of this trap reaction for phenolene preparation from aniline. So I guess this video may be useful for you. If it is, please help my channel to grow, because I need your motivation to continue my channel to make good videos for you, do some hard work. So I request you, please help me to grow my channel. First of all, subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. Secondly, share this video among your friends such that many people could be benefited from my effort. And most importantly, please like the video and make some good comment, because your like and comments are the motivation for me. And if you think some modification, improvement, rectification essential, please feel free to mention in the comment box. Thank you everyone. Stay happy, stay blessed. All the best.